Hello everyone, welcome to our Tuesday reflection. I greet you in the name of the Father, Son, and of the Holy Spirit. I hope that you are keeping well, and I hope you and your family are very well. And I hope that you are happy now that the shops are open and that you can go about and go into the shops. Today's reflection is from the book of Samuel, 1 Samuel chapter 1, from verses 9 to 11. 1 Samuel chapter 1, from verses 9 to 11. Let's hear the reading of God's word. So Hannah arose after they have finished eating and drinking in Shiloh. Now Eli the priest was sitting on the seat by the doorpost of the tabernacle of the Lord. And she was in bitterness of soul, and prayed to the Lord and wept in anguish. Then she made a vow and said, O Lord of hosts, if you will indeed look on the affliction of your maidservant, and remember me, and not forget your maidservant, but will give your maidservant a male child, then I will give him to the Lord all the days of his life, and no razor shall come upon his head. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Brothers and sisters, the background to this reading I've just had is about the story of Hannah and his husband Eli. Now, Eli was a priest in the tabernacle of the Lord in Israel. Hannah was barren. She didn't have any children. She was made mockery by her friends and people in society. Now, one would have thought that since her husband is the priest, that they will have a direct line to the throne of heaven or a direct line to God himself. But guess what? Hannah was going through the same thing that everybody goes through. So I want to announce to you this day that as a vicar, I am not exempt from the troubles and the challenges and the crisis of the world. However, what I can do is when they happen, I believe in the ability of God to overcome every situation. I believe that with God, all things are possible. And here, Hannah did that. Although her husband was the priest in Jerusalem, in the temple, Hannah didn't go to her husband to ask for prayer. Hannah prayed herself. We are told that Hannah was in bitterness of soul and she wept in anguish. But she did something else. She made a vow. She made a vow to the Lord and said to God, look, you man up there, if you will look upon your servant and if you will grant me a male child, I am making a vow. I want to make a deal with you. That if you give me that male child, I will give him back to you all the days of his life. Meaning that Hannah said to God, look, I want to cut a deal with you, God. If you will give me a male child, I want to make a vow that I will give that child back to you into your service. All the days of his life, he will serve you in your house. He will serve you in your church. He will serve your people. He made a vow to God that, look, if you give me this child, I will offer him back to you. And no razor will come upon his head. Meaning that Samuel was going to be a Nazarite. Somebody who has been set apart for the service of God. Brothers and sisters, guess what? For the fact that we have the book of Samuel, for the fact that we have 1 and 2 Samuel, for the fact that the prophet Samuel ministered mightily in scripture, means that God answered the prayer of Hannah. So my message to you today is this. God's message to you today is this. If you have something on your heart, and that particular thing on your heart has been long coming, you have prayed to God long enough, I want to encourage you that you need to make a vow to God. Whatever it is, I have made a vow to God before. When my wife was pregnant with Martin, according to consultant and medical experts, Sophia, my wife, was not going to have Martin successfully. In fact, she was written off by the doctors. But when we knew that she was pregnant, I fasted for 3 days. After that fasting, I sat in my study and I said to God, "Look, you man up there, according to the medical expert, this pregnancy is not supposed to happen. If you have managed to put a pregnancy in her womb, then it is now your responsibility for my wife to have a successful delivery." And brothers and sisters, that was my prayer after 3 days fasting. And I said to God, "If you give me this child, I will offer Martin back to you into your service." And so when Martin was born while I was studying in Cambridge, I took Martin into the chapel of my college and I offered Martin back to God. So what I'm saying is this: if you have something on your heart, if you have been praying for something and that thing has not been coming, or it appears that God is not answering your prayer, perhaps you should make a vow. Whatever that you are asking God for, I want you to cut a deal with God. Say to God, "God, if you do so, so and so and so for me, this is what I will do for you back." It may be that you are looking for a financial breakthrough. It may be that you are looking for a job. It may be that you are looking for a child, for the fruit of the womb. It may be that you are looking for a husband. It may be that you want to be successful in your college. You want to be successful in your career. It may be that you want to be successful at your university. It may be that you want to be successful in every area of your life. Brothers and sisters, I want you to go on your knees and pray to God. And I want you to cut a deal with God. Say to God, "If you are able to do this for me, if you are able to fulfill what I'm asking you to do for me, this is what I will do for you, A, B, C." And I want you to make that vow to God. And brothers and sisters, God who answered Hannah, God who gave Samuel to Hannah, God who allowed Hannah to conceive and have a child called Samuel, the prophet in the Old Testament, that God will meet you at the point of your need. That God will provide for you. That God will answer your prayer. All you have to do today is to make a vow to God. Cut a deal with God, because Hannah did it. Hannah said to God, "If you will give me a male child," in her case, she was looking for a male child, so she was specific. She said to God, "If you will give me a male child, after you have given that child to me, I will offer him back to you all the days of his life." So what is it that you are looking for God to do for you? Whatever it is, I want you to bring it to prayer to God. I want you to go on your knees and pray to God and say to God, "If you do this for me, I make a vow that if you do this for me, I will make an offering. If you give me a job, this is what I will do for you. If you give me a husband or a wife, this is what I will do for you. If you allow me to be successful in my exams, this is what I will do for you. If you allow me to find a job, this is what I will do for you. If you make me successful in my career, this is what I will do for you." And brothers and sisters, God who answered Hannah, God who allowed Hannah to have pregnancy and to deliver Samuel, that God will answer you. That God will meet you at the point of your need. All you have to do is to cut a deal with God. God will meet you at the point of your need. When you make a vow with God, when you cut a deal with God, God will see your anguish. God will see your pain. God will see your bitterness, and God will answer you. God will answer that prayer, and you will be happy in your life. Brothers and sisters, this day, God sent me to tell you that if you have been praying for something and that thing has not come, perhaps you should make a vow to God and cut a deal with God. Say to God, "This is what I will do for you if you answer me this prayer, and my God will supply you all of your need according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus." And so this day, brothers and sisters, do not be dismayed. Do not be perplexed. Do not be in pain. Do not be in anguish. All you have to do is to go on your knees and pray to God and make that vow, and God will meet you at the point of your need. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I will see you on Thursday. Shalom. Peace.
Ha 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 ha.